So I recorded in class my clown look, and I'm kind of sorry that I kind of got in the way and everything, but hopefully, you know, you still look at it, and if you want, I can do another one, but it'll be face paint instead of cream, because in class we use cream, and I was in a class, so there's not much noise, because I couldn't add music, because I didn't want to disturb everybody else, like, they pay to be here too, so, yeah, and then, I didn't want to, like, bother nobody. So, yeah. But, I hope you guys liked the video. I'm sorry I didn't talk through it because it was in class. I hope everything's very, like, easy to see what I did. If not, like I said, I can do another one explaining more. And, yeah. Like, love, subscribe, follow. I did go back and, like, edit how I did my eyebrows and some things you can't see, like the glitter on my chest. I know you guys can't see the glitter, but, like the glitter I added to my chest, my lips, I put it on my eyes. but yeah, and I didn't set it because the powder, like, is like this yellowish color, so it messes it up, but you should set it to make it like better, and I wiped it off like 2 minutes after I was done. So yeah, but I hope you guys like it. I really do, and I'm still gonna work on my channel and everything. I still got a lot to work on, so please forgive me for this messiness I got, but yeah.
Guys, so this is my clown makeup tutorial, kind of just like me doing my clown makeup in class. So I hope you guys enjoy. Here we go. Thank you.
So most of the time you make the pieces first and then apply them? And then you don't have to wait for the drying process? Maybe a lot easier. You should lay it. If you buy one of the silicone baking sheet things, you roll out that you make cookies on. Mm-hmm. You guys want to talk about it? You can go on there. You can do it. So that we get like a straight sheet of it. Mm-hmm. It just depends what you want. If you want something more like formed, then you want to take something that's got like a curve texture to it, mm-hmm. or a curve to it. You can use like a Pyrex bowl. Well, that, you know, the baking. Mm-hmm. You can use that. Some of them have like that ruffled edge like this. Mm-hmm. You can put that on there. That works for that too. Lots of choices. But this is the hardest way, so I guess you've done the hardest way first.
What days?
Friday and Saturday.
And it starts at 11?
That's the pre-show. The show starts at midnight.
So, if I can I come just to the show or are you?
Yeah.
Because I'm not eating out so
late. Oh my god, that's good.
Starts at midnight and it's over at like 1:40.
Then I'm not retired. So,
and then up, so
I go out.
And of course, I know who sent the list of stuff in. four different caskets up there. I'm like, which one do you want? Because I'm not pulling all of them. And so I'm waiting for her email, so I'll hear back from her.
I
generally when you do a makeup, you want to make sure you have all your research done first. Because then it's harder to find a picture of what you did than it is to do what you got a picture of.
Does that make sense? So you should, when you come in for your final, you should already, or for your final on that makeup, you should already have your pictures and have them printed out. So what about you just go back and just the lines in here? Because you're kind of like, you're not, like your circles aren't in there. And if you're going to do a grill, your eyebrows are in two different places. So you can probably make them a little bigger so that they match. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So just take a little bit more time and get them make it neat. Shape and the colors are good, they just need to be neater, that's all. week, and then we start working on the photos and latex.
Mm-hmm. And one of the cool things is they have the molds like this, and they're all silicone. So you know you can use just a baking sheet or a straight one, mm-hmm. but so you can cut pieces. Even my front top and bottoms are cool.
Are they cool?
There's a lot of them. Like scabs, wounds, and pretty cool, right? Mm-hmm. So we'll be working with these on. And pre-prep it so it doesn't, you don't have to breathe, or you don't have to poke holes in the right where your face is. So that'll be a lot easier for you guys.
Okay, horrible memory, and I run like 160 students, so it's hard for me to remember. I know your name, but we read it anyway. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay,
green a lot. It's kind of, it lends its own like evil quality to it.
Yeah, it kind of has like a neon look
mm-hmm.
too.
That looks great.
Thank you.
Thank you, sweetheart. Justine?
Is this better?
That's much better.
Yeah. I just decided to add the black line to the lips.
Yeah, that's awesome. What did you use to add the line? Pencil?
I just used black. Just the black. Then I used
okay. That's much better. You might want to consider using a pencil, like an eyebrow pencil. It's not going to be dark on your skin because you have the white, so it's going to show up as a lighter line.
Okay.
But it gives you an outline.
Okay.
And then you just fill to the end of that. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That'll make it a little bit more.
Can you sign it?
No. To make it a little bit more even for you.
Okay.
But that's much better.
Okay. So, can I take my pictures?
Yeah, you can.
My name is Soma.
Thank you.
Yeah,
like that.
Go ahead and do some research this week on bruises. So you already have a reference picture for what you're going to try to create. And then you'll learn how to create them in class.
Bless you.
Thank you.